Alzheimer's affects about 6 million Americans, yet there hasn't been a new treatment for the incurable disease in almost 20 years. Until recently, that is. Our medical correspondent, Dr. Sujatha Reddy, breaks it all down for us.
Dr. Reddy, thank you so much for being here. So what does this new drug mean for anyone who suffers with Alzheimer's?
Yeah, you know, it is good news that the FDA approved a new medication because we haven't had one for Alzheimer's in almost 20 years. This medicine is different. It is trying to attack the plaques in the brain that Alzheimer's patients seem to have that seem to cause the brain cells to die off that leads to the dementia. And Alzheimer's is the most common type of dementia. What's been a bit controversial about this drug is the benefit seems to be very marginal or minimal. It may help a little bit, but it's still exciting that there's something out there that we can sort of hope will improve, you know, the Alzheimer's patients', you know, cognitive function.
Sure, absolutely. I mean, hey, I'm sure for anyone out there who's suffering or who's a caregiver to a loved one, they're thinking any improvement is something. But let's talk about, so is that the caveat that the FDA approved it with?
Yeah, so the FDA wants there to be another trial to see really how significant is the benefit and to really make sure that there is benefit, because this medication does have some pretty serious side effects. It comes with a very large price tag, and it's not an easy medicine to take. It's not just a pill a day. It's actually an IV infusion for an hour once a month. And if a patient is on this medication, they actually have to get frequent brain scans because some of the complications involve brain swelling, brain hemorrhages. So it's not a benign medication. But again, it is exciting that there is a new type of medicine to address Alzheimer's. And maybe this is the start of, you know, down the road where we're going to get other medications. And I think that's the exciting part.
Exactly. Maybe this is just the beginning, especially as you said, since there hasn't been any kind of new treatment in almost 20 years. So on the other side of it, what can we do in our daily lives to really improve our brain function? I know even, you know, from my mom, who's going to be 80, to myself, who's 52, every day I feel like, you know, you get slower, your recall. So there are practical things we can do, right?
Yeah, there really are. So, you know, some of the things that lead up to Alzheimer's are not going to be in your control, like genetic factors, your family history. But we think that living a healthy lifestyle may decrease your risk or help prevent it or put it off. And that is all the stuff that we should all be doing for other health conditions too. So one thing is absolutely don't smoke. Be physically active. Exercise is really good. If you have anything like high blood pressure or any other kind of cardiovascular disease, make sure you're following up with your care for that. Take your medications. Try to learn new things, like keep your brain active, like brain puzzles may be helpful, but really, and get good sleep if you can. That's a really good way to sort of keep your immune system functioning well, but really just being a healthy, fit person may help keep your brain healthy and fit too. So those are all the things I would recommend that we should all be doing anyway.
Exactly. Thank you, doctor. I appreciate you enlightening us with more information about this topic, and we just so appreciate your time.
Always good to see you. Thank you, Christine.